Hello, ladies and gentlemen. In the following presentation, we will try to demonstrate the innovative bike memory service which is being applied in our facilities since March 2018. Due to the current situation of COVID-19, the visiting of the patients from family and friends has been forbidden since March 2020 nationwide for all rehabilitation centers in Greece. This situation has caused a great deal of disturbance for our patients, who in their majority are suffering from dementia. However, the bike memory service has worked as a stimulus engine for our people, making them feel less lonely and more active. Specifically, having observed the application of the service for the past 2 years, we've come to realize that the bike memory service has triggered our patients to express more intense feelings, such as laughter, singing, dancing, also remembering favorite activities from their past, and also get emotional about past experiences. And this is exactly the reason why we are presenting this innovative service to you today for the world to know the benefits of this unique application. But what exactly is the bike memory service? It's a non-pharmaceutical form of intervention to the person with dementia causing mental stimulation through which the person receives audiovisual stimuli from the pleasant memories of his life and physical stimulation which is achieved by non-simultaneous movement of upper and lower limbs. So the hippocampus is activated, the part of the brain associated with memories and emotions. At the same time, though, the movement of upper and lower limbs mobilizes the joints, helps to avoid possible thrombosis, activates the intestine, and activates partially recovered muscle skeletal disorders. Now, the bike memory service is offered through a static exercise bike, which can either be used manually or by feet, or even combined. This is a huge advantage because even people with disabilities such as blindness, deafness, or even mobility issues can even use this service. The bike fits into a wheelchair based on each individual's body type. It includes a large screen through which edited videos are displayed that are created based on the person's pleasant memories and favorite activities. Our 10-minute videos are edited and have the following layout. An approximate 3-minute projection of one or two favorite visiting places accompanied by favorite musical abstracts. An approximate 3-minute projection of a favorite movie or theatrical comedy or a video mix of their favorite comedian. An approximate 3-minute projection of favorite arts, sports, historical events, and cultural sites. The pleasant memories and favorite activities are selected from a history of individual's life questionnaire, which is completed by the person's close relatives and the individual itself. The questionnaire on which the videos are based on include information such as place of birth, origin, places one lived, favorite destinations, the jobs he or she worked in, studies, religion, art, theater and cinema, music, sports, politics, even favorite animals and plants. The procedure begins with the individual sitting in a wheelchair that adjusts to the bicycle. At the beginning of the process, the following measures are monitored: the blood pressure, the oxygen, and pulse. The duration lasts about 10 minutes and the arms and feet speed is adjusted by the bicycle software. The occupational therapist is close to the individual and monitors his or her reactions. The session ends with a repetition of the aforementioned measurements as well as the evaluation of the whole session, which is recorded to special reports. The process can be described as a memory virtual walk, and the recommended frequency is up to 3 times a week, depending on the person. Finally, after having observed a significant number of cases within the past 2 years, we've come to the conclusion that the bike memory service contributes significantly to the memory stimulation, limb mobilization, and entertainment. The creation of the videos highlights favorite destinations, music, and especially comic excerpts from movies that used to make the individual laugh. It can be used either to confront upper or lower limb problems or hearing or vision problems. Of course, the most important is that the results of the session help the doctor understand and detect the change in the stage of dementia. Following, we can see a video demonstration of a 67-year-old individual who suffers from Alzheimer's disease. Based on the individual's answers on the questionnaire, we used information such as favorite place to visit is Venice. He was born and lived in Chicago, where he worked as an oil painter. His favorite comedian is Charlie Chaplin. Favorite songs are A Casa di Renne by Nico Fidenco and the theme song Sirtaki from the movie Zorba the Greek. Moreover, he admires figure skating.
I giorni grigi sono le lunghe strade silenziose di un paese deserto e senza cielo.
A casa di Rene si canta, si ride, c'è gente che viene, c'è gente che va. A casa di Rene bottiglie di vino, a casa di Rene stasera si va.
Giorni senza domani e il desiderio di te. Sono quei giorni che sembrano fatti di pietra, niente altro che un muro sormontato da cocci di bottiglia. Poi ci sei tu a casa di Irene e quando mi vedi tu corri da me, mi guardi negli occhi, mi prendi la mano ed in silenzio mi porti con te.
A casa di Irene si canta, si ride, c'è gente che viene, c'è gente che va. A casa di Irene bottiglie di vino, a casa di Irene stasera si va.
If you also want to be part of a wider scope to inform and interact with professionals worldwide and exchange views and experiences in matters relating to the challenges of dementia and other neurological diseases, as also handling suggestions, just subscribe, click like, and hit the bell to become part of a wider community with an excellent purpose.